Richard Axel is comfortable in the junior. 10 laps in the books. Richards will be your leader. Then Overton, McCready, Owen, Strickler in 5th. Shepard, Clinton, Thornton Jr., Moran, Lanigan in 10th.
So far, it's been very entertaining up front there. Of course, Ben Schaller making the trip to the hot pits as well. It looks like, speaking of Moyers, Billy Moyer Sr. also in the hot pits right now as we have the crew on board trying to see what they're looking at there. It looks like they're digging some of the dirt off the spoiler, maybe a left rear tire, maybe losing air on the 21 machine. It looks like they've got him off the Jackson, just about ready to send him back out. As it looks like Kevin Lane is going to take a quick run at the officials.
So right now, we still have 30 cars on the track. We started with 31. Billy Moyer Jr. I'll try to find out exactly what happened to him. What's up here? Richards. Overton did lead lap number 6. Richards got back around him, and that Clint Boyer 14. As they come out of turn Peterson Jr., Tanner English, Tyler Bruning, and then we'll have Chris Simpson, Tad Pospisil, Hudson O'Neill, Chase Younghan, still on the scoring monitor. Simpson pulls away the Okotrunky in the customs 32. So again, here's Matt Scott, Billy Collier, Shatter, Ian Hercules Jr., and Billy Collier Jr. So we got the race. So deep right there, that was a long stretch of green flag racing. There's Hudson O'Neill, PCC Motorsports, Dustin Nobby up into that car. The base of Indiana Lake Model Racer.
Yeah, so we got Tad Pospisil right beside him.
Dave, down to you.
Well, chassis adjustments for Chris Simpson the same on the rear end of Hudson O'Neill. They're trying to get him going. He needed a bump start right there. Tad Pospisil looks like they're thrashing with the rear end.
Thank you.
bottom. He's taking a look up there in turn four at the top. We'll see what he decides. As you see, the right rear off the one of the Eric and Kelly Block Best Performance Rocket Chassis car.
Take a toll, especially on the sneakers, as English gets a new right rear bolted onto the 81E machine.
And again, these guys running for one service, so counterpart working the chase, the Outlaw working the chase.
not come back full-time and do it. I think a lot of fans out there would as well. As you see Steve Francis taking a look, and that's no. They're going to take the hood off. Gloves are off. Now they're going to be neck restraint. One great run for Chad Blaine after a year off of racing. Toby Ellis hit the long point for a long time. It's going to be the first time to be on. 70 laps in the books, 10 to go. But I tell you what, these modified options, Ricky Thorne Jr. and Kyle Strickler, they belong in dirt late model racing full time. They are putting on a show here tonight, and we've seen that for the better part of the last 4 or 5 months.
I'll tell you what, I thought that was a trend that was going to subside the last couple of years. It looked like it's kind of all the way 5 years ago. The United States took a crack at late models, and they've been posting up some good results. It looks like they're almost working on Ricky Thorne Jr. They are continuing to
he's wore out, and he keeps himself in pretty good shape, but we don't want these cars, as Brian Burkhofer told me a few years ago. I mean, you got noodle arms there, you haven't driven for a while, but he was on the show with Jared Landers from 20th to 6th.
I mentioned that was this race, replacing the